take a moment to say the Pledge of Allegiance with me. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Congratulations to both the girls' and boys' basketball teams for their wins on Tuesday evening. The girls destroyed General John Stricker with a score of 49-4, while the boys more than doubled their points again against Stricker with a score of 65-32. They are still undefeated. I look forward to seeing what you guys do tonight. Student Council and NJHS are sponsoring a Holiday Spirit Week next week, December 20th through the 23rd. On Monday, wear your holiday headwear or your holiday crazy socks. On Tuesday, wear your holiday colors, whether you celebrate Kwanzaa, Christmas, or Hanukkah. On Wednesday, wear your flannel or dress like your favorite holiday character. And on Thursday, wear that ugly sweater and show everybody your holiday spirit.
Hello, I'm Jacqueline Woodson, and I'm the author of Brown Girl Dreaming, Each Kindness, Pecan Pie Baby, and If You Come Softly, among many others. The title of my new middle grade book is Harbor Me. Harbor Me is the story of six young people who are in a combined fifth, sixth grade class. And one Friday, the teacher announces to them that she's going to put them into a classroom for an hour every Friday at the end of the school day where she won't be in the classroom with them, where they'll be there alone to just talk. And the kids are very resistant to this because they don't understand why. And eventually they begin to understand. Harbor Me covers a number of themes. I think it covers what it means to be family, and that one child is being raised by her uncle. It covers what it means to be good friends and what it means to take care of each other. The theme of deportation and loss, what it means to be a black boy in this country, what does it mean to be an American citizen and watch your friends get taken away. So lots goes on. I think the biggest inspiration for Harbor Me was asking myself the question, what would it mean to put six young people in a room to talk? What would they say? What would they think? What would they do? Would they misbehave? Would they act the fool? Or would they really talk? Or would they do all of that? And then to begin to create characters. I don't think I've ever created a book with this many characters in it, all who have very strong personalities. But some of the stuff they say is really funny. Some of it is really thoughtful. Some of it is really evocative. And you come to know their lives through the narrative.
Attention Yearbook Club members, those who have turned in their applications. Yearbook Club will meet on Thursday, December 9th, and again on Thursday, December 16th from 3:05 to 4:05. So please make sure that your ride is here at 4:05 on each day. We didn't have a lot of entries for our Christmas holiday rebus puzzle with the rocks around the Christmas tree. Now, a lot of people wrote rocks around the Christmas tree, but that wasn't what the picture was showing. Congratulations to the following students for correctly identifying that it was the holiday song Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree. Edward Mizell, Akira Grant, Tyler Will, Chloe Critch, and Ernest Mayorko. Congratulations, Eagle Bucks are in the Eagle Buck Pit.
It is time for I Am Smarticus. When you find out the answer to the question that follows, message Muzhil, and if your answer is correct, your name will be added to the Wall of Smartacuses.
Lasers have been the weapon of choice for space movies and science fiction. But believe it or not, one country in our world has successfully fired a laser weapon in the Gulf of Aden. Which country has successfully fired a laser weapon?
Think, think, think. Think, think, think. Think, think, think. I've got to think, 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 think.
For the remainder of 2021, we will end our broadcast news with an inspirational story rather than the meditation moment. 'Tis the season to think about all of mankind and how we can all be an inspiration to each other.
Fun fact, planet Earth is 4.5 billion years old. Mankind, about 140,000 years old. Let me put that in perspective. If you condense the Earth's lifespan into 24 hours, that's one full day, then we have been here on this planet for, drum roll please, 3 seconds. 3 seconds. And look what we've done. We have modestly named ourselves Homo sapiens, meaning wise man. But is man really so wise? Smart, yes, and it's good to be smart, but not too smart for your own good. Yes, we have split the atom. Yes, we build clever machines that navigate the universe in search of new homes, but at the same time, those atoms we split created nuclear warfare. In our quest to explore the galaxy rejects and neglects the home that we have here now, so no, that cannot be wisdom. Wisdom is different. While intelligence speaks, wisdom listens, and we willingly covered our ears to Mother Nature's screams and closed our eyes to all of her help-wanted signs. Wisdom knows that every action has an equal and opposite reaction, so if we were wise, we would not be shocked when we see storms that are stronger than ever before, or more drought, hurricanes, and wildfire than ever before, because there's more pollution than ever before, more carbon, more trees cut down than ever before. At a record pace, we have increased the extinction of animals by 1,000 times the normal rate. What a feat. In the next 10 to 100 years, every beloved animal character in every children's book is predicted to go extinct. Lions gone, rhinos gone, tiger, gorilla, elephant, polar bear gone in 3 seconds. Species that have been here longer than us will be gone because of us in this 3 seconds. In an existence shorter than a Vine video, we turn the circle of life into our own personal conveyor belt. Somebody, anybody, help. We were given so much. The only planet in this solar system with life. I mean, we are one in a million. No, actually, scientifically, we are one in a billion, trillion, trillion. That's a one followed by 33 zeros. And I don't want to get too spiritual, but how are we not a miracle? We are perfectly positioned to the sun so we don't burn, but not too distant so we don't turn to ice. Goldilocks said it best. We are just right. This paradise where we are given medicine from trees, not coincidentally, but because like the song says, we are family. Literally, everything, every species is connected genetically from the sunflower to the sunfish. And this is what we must recognize before it's too late, because the real crisis is not global warming, environmental destruction, or animal agriculture. It is us. These problems are symptoms of us, byproducts of us, our inner reflection. Loss of connection has created this misdirection. We have forgotten that everything contributes to the perfection of Mother Nature. Corporations keep us unaware and disconnected, but they have underestimated our strength. Contrary to popular belief, millions are waking up out of their sleep, seeing our home being taken right up under our feet. We cannot allow our history to be written by the wicked, greedy, and loony. It is our duty to protect Mother Nature from those who refuse to see her beauty. Call me crazy, but I believe we should have the right to eat food that's safe, with ingredients we can pronounce, drink water that is clean, marvel at trees, breathe air free of toxins. These are natural rights, not things that can be bargained for in Congress. See, they want you to feel powerless, but it has been said that something as small as the flutter of a butterfly's wing can cause a typhoon halfway around the world. But when enough people come together, we too will will make waves and wash the world into a new era filled with love and connection, freedom for all without oppression. But it is up to you, yes, you watching this behind this screen, to make the effort, because time is of the essence, and only together can we make it to the fourth second.